Hi guys, welcome back. This week we are not going to cook, but I want to give you some interesting information about nuts and seeds, and I'm sure that most of you don't know. We all know that they're terrific nutrition dense food, but most of you don't know that on the way we eat it, or most of us eat it, they're actually blocking their nutrition and the body is not absorbing. So they are plants, so they are rich in phytic acid and enzyme inhibitors. And phytic acid is usually the biological necessary ingredient which is acting like self-guard. It's actually saving the nuts and seeds itself in the soil not to get moldy and stay safe till proper growing condition present. So in the end, we are not plants, so we don't need these inhibitors in our body, and they're blocking our digestive system, and we have very easy way to prevent this. Otherwise, those foods can cause nutrition deficits and digestive system irritations, and it's especially important for kids who are still not developed their enzyme system to break those plant ingredients inside of those foods. So Even if these foods are very rich in nutrition, proteins and vitamins and things like that, it doesn't mean that the way we eat it, we are absorbing them. Even phytic acid in certain levels can play protective role in the body and even plays as a messenger role in the cells. It needs to have certain levels of vitamins and minerals to do so. And in our modern diet nowadays, you can guess that's not the case. Just because you imagine that everybody is eating those foods not on the right way, and actually we're blocking our digestive system, we're having all kinds of deficits and a lot of problems with stools, gases and things like that. And there is easy way to have these problems away from us, and this is just by simple step of soaking them. But this step is hard to be done in processed market foods and restaurants. So I can tell you that soaking is super easy step. It's inexpensive and it's not time consuming at all. But this one, it's actually providing your body to have the proper nutrition from those ingredients and foods. And I can tell you that the sad news here are actually not only nuts and seeds are having those phytic acid and enzyme inhibitors. Also legumes and most of the grains do as well. And you can imagine that in modern diet nowadays, we are eating mostly those type of foods. So we are actually blocking our own digestive system, and this caused us a lot of problems. And that's one of the reasons that most of the people these days have deficits, digestive problems, and they need to take a lot of pills to have their body working properly. And I can give you an example with myself that I have a medical condition which actually it's costing me to take pills every day. They used to tell me that I have to take pills like 5-6 times a day with multivitamins, calcium, magnesium, phytic acid and many more. And you imagine that last year, when I was diagnosed with cancer, my oncologic doctor told me that I cannot have any supplements because by having them, I will go to actually I'll increase my cancer cells. They're gonna grow faster from the supplements. And actually, that's another topic which I want to talk about, that we should take care of our digestive system and to take all the nutrition naturally from our food and the things which we eat, and not having supplements, because actually could cause mutation cells to grow faster and have problems with cancer and other conditions. And interesting enough that I stopped all the supplements last year, and everybody thought that, even me and doctors, that I'll have deficits. I'll have low calcium, magnesium, and all the vitamins and minerals which I'm having, because I am not supposed to have them normally because of my condition. And imagine what, I'm having no of those deficits which everybody was worrying about. And I'm sure here that because I'm taking a lot of care of my digestive system, of my microflora, and I start soaking everything and eating the food in proper way, actually I'm absorbing all the nutrition inside of my food. So let's tell you how to soak them and stop telling you what kind of benefits it has these steps. It takes basically two parts of doing them, and here you can see in some of my previous video when I show you that you just put the nuts or whatever you need to soak, you add warm water, salt, and wait the time which need to be waited. Warm water, it's having the benefit of actually neutralizing the folic acid, and the salt is helping to activate enzymes which are deactivating the those enzyme inhibitors which are needed for plants to stay safe. But as you know, we are not plants, so we don't need this to block our system. And interesting fact is that different nuts, seeds, legumes, and grains take different time to be soaked. And I'm gonna make, actually I did a schedule for you with all of those, and I'm gonna give you a link later on which you can download and have this one and use it when you need. For example, cashew needs 2 to 4 hours, almond needs 8 to 12 hours, pistachio doesn't need to be soaked, and I'm gonna give you a plan with these things. And in beginning, when I wanted to actually when I learned that I have to soak all of these ingredients, I was pretty scared that it will be very hard, time consuming, I wouldn't like it, I wouldn't do it, and things like that. Actually, it's pretty simple. Usually I put them in the evening, and again I'll show you the simple steps. And I put them in the evening, I soak them during night, mostly the things which takes more than 10-12 hours, and in the morning I put the ones which takes like 2 to 4 hours. And I have to be honest with you that sometimes I don't follow exactly the hours, but you can see if it's a few hours more and the conditions and weather, it's okay. If they don't get moldy, it's still fine, and you can simply taste the taste and the skin of the nuts which or seeds which you're soaking, and you can actually feel once they are done. And for example, if I soak some beans and lentils or something which I want to cook from previous day, and next day turns out that I'm super busy and I cannot do it, I have to be honest with you, I just drain it down, put it in the fridge, and you know, you slow down the process of those molds and stuff like this, so it's safe for one day, and I actually could go for 2 days. But that's another topic. So actually it's not that time consuming that it seems to. I have found out that soaked nuts and seeds are actually having better taste for me than the other ones which are regular or baked. And of course in beginning I was thinking that I won't like the taste, and very often I bring some of those nuts with me like a snack when I'm out with my friends and people around me, and of course they try those nuts, and I saw that even some of my friends start soaking them, not because of the taste, not because of the benefits, but because of the taste, just because they like it more. So if you think that you won't like it, just try it on and you're gonna see that actually the taste is a lot more welcoming for us, and it's really nice. And I can show you actually the way which I start doing them in beginning when I find out that I need to soak nuts. I just took a box that's for some tools, you can see, and I put those kind of molds for cupcakes and things like that. And I prepare all type of nuts which I'm eating daily, because I have my own way of what type of nuts, how many to eat, and reasons why I'm doing that. So I prepare this one, and every evening I just take one of those, put it in warm water, salt, and in the next day add the ones which takes only a few hours, and in the evening, actually evening in the afternoon, I usually have my snack with this. But there is one problem with those, just because you have to eat it wet or right away. I don't mind the taste, they taste super amazing, actually I prefer them now, but if you don't eat them, they actually start to mold very fast and be not good for you anymore. So I found another way which I start doing lately. I bought the dehydrator, and once I soak them, I just drain them, and I am actually soaking a huge amount of nuts. Like I take 2-3 different types, and I do all of them, soaking all of them, and next day I put them in the dehydrator. That's a very cheap one, and just I have 2-3 different layers of those. I put them and dehydrate them. If you don't have dehydrator, it's not a problem for you at all. You can put just a paper towel for a paper sheet for baking and bake it on lowest temperature of your oven. That's like 150 Fahrenheit or 65 degrees Celsius. And how I store them and what I find out, I'm gonna show you now. That's this box. And you can see I just put all type of nuts which I'm using and different layers. And you can see I just take as much as I like, again, on my understandings, how much I want to eat daily. And it's interesting that this box I keep in the fridge. I know this is another topic, but I keep this box in the fridge. And I want to tell you that I'm not eating almost any type of other fats but nuts. I follow, as you know, anti-cancer protocol, which is cutting them out, and I eat only 2-3 types of oils. And believe me, I'm not eating most of the most famous oils which everybody consider as healthy, like olive oil and others. But I'm eating those nuts, so it's very important to take them on proper way. And as you saw, this box is very important for me to get it on the right way. And I'm keeping them in the fridge, as I told you. And the reason for that there is a connection between fatty nuts and seeds and temperature. And for this connection, I'm gonna tell you some other time. And as everybody know me, they know how much I like to talk, but I think the video is coming too long now, so we're gonna cut it here about this topic. But there is really huge connection between fats and temperature. Actually, that's one of the reasons that I'm not using nut milks like soya milk, almond milk and others, just because most of the people are actually cooking with them, and I believe this is not good to get this high temperature used. Don't forget to subscribe the channel. This way you won't miss this video in future. And if you have any questions, just ask me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, or doing comments below. And if you like the video, just give me a thumb up and just stay a few more minutes, seconds actually, just because I'm gonna give you this link, which I promise you, with different soaking time for all the products and ingredients. And I'm gonna give you some bonus links with recipes which I made so far. It's going to be a recipe for 3 different dressings made out of nuts. It's going to be quinoa recipe, which is all gluten, dairy free, and in my opinion super tasty, and lentil cream soup, which takes only a few minutes to be made. And see you next Sunday with another amazing topic helping you to stay healthy and good. Ciao, see you next Sunday. Hi back! I'm back with the links which I promise you. Here is the quinoa bread, and here it's all the 3 different dressing recipes. Here it's the lentil cream soup, and as we say, it's promise, here is the link for all the ingredients and time for soaking. And that's my Facebook page, so don't forget, once you download it, to give a thumb up and follow the page as well. Ciao! See you next Sunday!